Hello, my friends. It's 11th of May today, and it looks like finally spring is approaching Stockholm in Sweden. Trees are getting a little bit green by now. The leaves are not really out in the south of Sweden. We are already, but not here. It's still quite cool. We have 9 degrees, so not really perfect motorcycle weather, but at least you see a nice bright sky today. And the sun is just disappearing there on the horizon. Before it does that, I would like to show you some of the modifications, or basically all of the modifications I have done on the Africa Twin. Nothing big, but a few nice details which I find useful for my bike. So let me walk you around the Africa Twin right now. So here it is, my 2016 Africa Twin. In the nice red color, the one I really like. And let's see if I can show you some of the things I have modified on that bike, or added to the bike. The one you see already here, if I get that focused, that's the hand protectors. I bought them from SW Motec, but basically they are bug busters. We have this nice aluminium bar which goes all around the front and then connects to a nice massive clamp here on the handlebar. And what you also see if I do like this is that I have swapped the clutch and the brake lever. These are adjustable levers from Touratech. I'm honestly not a fan of Touratech too much. One reason is that I think their products in Sweden are horribly overpriced. They are 40% more expensive than in Germany. So I ordered that stuff to my sister in Germany, actually. And the clue about those levers is that they fold up, we have a link there, they fold up in case you drop the bike and the hand protector would move upwards. That's the alternative to breaking one. At the other hand, I have to admit, if I had saved the money, I could probably have bought 10 of the conventional clutch and brake levers for that. Let's go into the front of the bike. You see also there a nice detail, that's these diving goggles, if you want to call it like those. The headlight protectors in plexiglass, which should actually protect the headlights from flying stones. My guess is if you break one of those original headlights that you probably need to replace the complete unit. I know BMW does it like that, you're not able to buy only the glass in the front. So that is quite a damage. It should be covered by insurance, but at least I'm saving hopefully some money on the self-risk. You also see you got the same handguard of course on the other side. And I just realized when I drove here, which was the first time I'm using them, that they actually give a nice wind protection with the summer gloves I was wearing right now. If we move downward, you also see that I have replaced the foot pegs. Also those are from Touratech, because I found those to be the ones which are, well, give you best value for money in that case. There are some American makers, but I thought they were horribly expensive, and they are quite a bit wider than the original Honda foot pegs. So for standing riding, we give you much better platform to put your feet on. I'm wearing quite hard boots, so the sole doesn't get bent that much, but it still is more comfortable standing on these wider platforms compared to the really tiny original Honda foot pegs. You see, I have not replaced the exhaust, and I have no plans about doing that. Okay, there might be some weight saving, but I think sound-wise, I don't want the bike to sound louder. If you wear earplugs, I find that filtering away the wind noise gives you actually a quite a nice motor sound, engine sound. And you see there's a little Moto Moscomoto heat shield on the exhaust for these Reckless 80 bags I am using. The one thing you might realize here on the top, that's a homemade construction, is this luggage plate, which replaces the rear seat. I have used the screw mounts, that's on the back, which also Touratech uses for the pannier racks. And there's a metal L below that one, which goes to the original screws, which holds that aluminium plate. It's a 4 millimeter, I think, aluminium plate in place. There's still some space under it, so I have some tools under that. And I can quite quickly access that by just taking out 4 screws with the onboard tools, which I have under the seat or in the original toolbox. The idea behind that is that you see the platform is a little bit lower than the original seat was. So if I have the Moscomodo bags on the back of the bike, I am getting a little space below them, about 5 to 10 centimeters. And that is very nice to put in some extra stuff, to store some extra stuff, like shoes, for example. Haven't tried that yet. These modifications are also brand new. The aluminium plate is powder coated, so it should last some time and the paint doesn't come off. Right the opposite of the original passenger handlebar, which I've simply wrapped with electric tape now to save the paint a little bit. I do have also, again, Touratech, the engine guard down there, at least to protect the clutch and the alternator caps in case you crash. I didn't want to have the big ones. Hopefully I will not need the big crash bars which go all the way to the top, because I find these too heavy and too obtrusive. I wanted to keep the bike slim and simple. You also see one thing. Down there, on every side, I have mounted 2 LED lights. That's very cheap, 5-watt LEDs, coming from the local car accessory discounter, costing about 350 Swedish crowns, 35 euros each. So these give me an additional light, not for seeing more, but for being better seen. And I'd like to see if I can switch that on and show you how that looks like from the front. So you see, this is the normal illumination you have on the bike. The right headlight is on, low beam, and these 2 extra little 5-watt LED lights down there give quite a remarkable light, which I think make me much better visible in everyday traffic. The last one I'd like to quickly show you is my GPS holder, which is mounted on the original crossbar behind the screen. Actually, a Honda representative told me, yes, this is intended for a GPS. I hope he is right. Some people have been reporting that that bar could break if you have a heavy GPS on it. So I hope it doesn't do that. I hope the Honda rep is right. He recommended the SW Motec holder, but what I have done is I've built myself one based on the RAM mount system and the original Garmin holder for the Montana 600. And to clamp it, I used some aluminium blocks, which normally are sold to attach hydraulic lines on heavy building equipment. So those definitely should last. I recently also clamped a little bit of rubber just below it, just experimentally to reduce vibrations, because this is already quite a long lever, unfortunately, which gives some shaking there. I have to experiment a little bit more with that. So these are the modifications I wanted to show you. But most important, remember, hand wash only. Have a nice time. Enjoy riding.